Yesterday, hold on. So let me tell you about my vacation. First of all, first day here, first full day when we got out of bed. I'm driving everyone crazy because, like, I'm trying to get ready for George St. Pierre at the same time. So I'm getting out of bed early and I'm going for runs and all this type of stuff. And of course, my wife just wants to, you know, she's on vacation, so she wants to take it easy. But we're having these little mini arguments every day because I'm like, right, come on, let's go. And they're like, Michael, are you serious? It's only 8 o'clock. I'm lying in bed for another 30 minutes. I'm like, well, we haven't spent all this money to come to bloody Hawaii to lie in bed all day, you know. So anyway, we go out the other day. We go to this place called the Bamboo Forest, which is very, very cool. You go through like this bamboo forest, obviously, and then you find this waterfall. You climb up the waterfall, you keep going through some rocks, you find another waterfall, you keep going and going and going. And eventually, you come to a river, you stash your bags, you swim down a river, and then you come to this glorious waterfall. It takes a while, it takes a full day to do it. It's beautiful, absolutely amazing. Come back, the pain in the ass part, of course, is you got to come back. So obviously we've got the kids as well, so climbing up these waterfalls is very, very treacherous. I'm absolutely shitting my pants, but kids have no fear. You know what I mean? As you get older, you just don't care about... Or I guess you don't realize the consequences of falling down a jagged waterfall. You know what I mean? Because I was terrified. I said, right, we got to stop. We can't go any further. They're like, no, Dad, are you serious? And they all climbed up and made me look like a pussy. So I had to continue. Anyway, eventually we come back. We make it back to the car. After getting lost, at one point we were lost in the bamboo forest. It was at the end of the day. It was starting to get dark. And we couldn't find the fucking car. And I'm, you know, running down this path, running down that path, going through mud. You know, by the end, it's a bit embarrassing, but we're having to go, help, help, trying to see if anyone, you know, anyway, we found some people and they're like, yeah, you just got to cross the river, go up there. So that was a little embarrassing, but we emerged onto the road. It was almost dark and we walk up to the car and Callum says, oh, someone smashed the window. And I thought he was kidding. And the little fuckers, yep, lo and behold, smashed the window. My wife had left her bag in the trunk or in the boot. And, smashed the window, grabbed that, had all the clothes in, because, of course, we were swimming through waterfalls and whatnot, so I just had a tiny pair of shorts on. My wife was in a bikini, you know, and that's kind of how we were dressed. All the clothes, stuff like that was all stolen, including my wallet, ID, everything. So
credit cards.
That was a bit of a bummer. Say again?
They took your credit cards and everything?
Credit cards, the lot. Fortunately, we had one card back at the hotel.
Yeah. Well, that's the thing that sucks, though, because then it's not even like, look, it sucks, but you go, you're not poor, you're not desolate, you didn't lose that much, right? You cancel the cards. But what sucks is you're on vacation, and now you're spending your afternoon calling credit card companies, filing a police report. You know, it's just the time that they take away from you. I had money taken out of a hotel room once in Puerto Rico, and it was like $150. It wasn't the end of the world, but the wild goose chase that they sent me on to speak to a manager and fill out this thing and do this other thing. I'm like, I wasted half of a day of vacation. Oh, you know, that was what I was more upset about.
Well, that's the thing. Exactly. I mean, as you say, I mean, I was in good spirits about it. If you check my Instagram, you see a video on there. Sorry, a picture. The police are dusting for fingerprints and I've got a big grin on my face because I thought it was hilarious for some reason. But then they were dusting for fingerprints on a smashed window. You know, you think they'd have better things to do, but I guess not. On a tiny island like Maui. But, you're right. It was just cards, you know. And I even said, listen, me and my wife, we've been together 18 years. And that's the first time we've been robbed. So I'm like, well, you know, it's not bad. Not bad. And they took the credit cards. That's easy. We canceled them. The hire car, we were supposed to take it straight back. But as you say, you don't want to waste half a day taking a fucking rental car back. So I'm yet to do that. So we're driving around with a smashed window. And we got robbed a second time. Because my running trainers, my running shoes and stuff like that, I left them in the next day, and then when we got the car out of the valet, someone had stuck the fucking hand in and took the running shoes. But I, as you say, I don't want to waste half a day going to the fucking rental car place and doing that. Anyway, yesterday, we met up with an old friend of mine, Kendall Grove. I don't know if you saw season 3 of The Ultimate Fighter. Kendall Grove won 185, the middleweight division. I won the light heavyweight division at 205 and hung out on the beach with his family. It was a great day, and he's... you know, they had some kayaks there for us. They had some paddle boards and stuff like that. And they say, let's get on the paddle boards and go out to that cliff over there. And this cliff's like, you know, it's way off in the distance. And you can climb up the cliff and you can jump off the cliff and all this. So, yeah, all right, cool. So we jump on and there's me and my daughter, I think, on the paddle board. And then in the kayak is my wife, my son, and Kendall Grove's sister-in-law. So we go off, we get to the cliff. Long story short, we, you know, do some cliff jumping. That's all well and good. I said, okay, the wind's picking up. We better get back. So we start heading off. And it's me and my daughter on a paddleboard. And listen, balancing on a paddleboard is not my forte. Let me just tell you that. Especially when there's two people on there and the winds are blowing like crazy. So we're trying to swim. We're trying to paddle back. And we're getting nowhere because of the wind. And then they're in a kayak, so they leave. They leave. Everyone's gone. We're out pretty far out in the ocean. I'm not going to lie. It was pretty far out around this cliff. The cliff was about, I don't know, 200-300 meters away from us. We're drifting further and further out. And I'm like, holy shit. And I don't want to say anything to my daughter, but I'm starting to panic a little bit. You know what I mean? And we're getting nowhere. I'm trying to paddle and getting nowhere. So I think, right, the bright idea, because we were weighing down the paddleboard. You know what I mean? So we were kind of going underwater a little bit. So I said, right, well, I'll jump off the paddleboard and I'll swim and try and pull you, right? And I said, you carry on paddling. So I jump off. My daughter's on the paddleboard. We're drifting further and further out to sea. And I'm not starting to panic. I'm trying to swim and we're getting nowhere. And about 15 minutes pass and we're in the exact same position. I'm like, shit.
And your daughter doesn't know there's anything going on wrong right now?
No, she's oblivious to it. I think she is anyway. She's 14. She probably doesn't know. And I'm like, fuck.
She's thinking
fuck.
About Justin Bieber, her boyfriend at school, heads in the clouds.
And I'm like, we're going to die. Right? And a bit of time passed, and I'm thinking, why is nobody coming to help us? And I'm starting to get stressed. So I think we're going to die. And, you know, we're out there, and as I say, we're getting nowhere. The wind's picking up. It's getting worse and worse. And I'm thinking, shit. You know, my daughter is completely oblivious to it. And I'm thinking, where the hell is everybody? Where is the lifeguard? Where's, you know, the knight in shining armor? So as I say, I'm swimming. And then to top it off, to make matters worse, in the distance, I hear, help, help. And I look round, and I see some arms flailing about in the water, not too far away from us. And I hear, help, help. I'm thinking, oh, shit. You know, I'm about to die as it is.
Tell me it's Jorge Masvidal.
Yeah, fuck that guy. So I swim over, right? I swim over to get the old lady. I get there. It's an old lady. She's massively overweight. She's got a snorkel around the head. And she's, oh, I'm going to drown. And I'm thinking, what the fuck are you doing out here with no life jacket, no boat, no nothing? And she's drowning. So I bring her over. She grabs onto the paddleboard, right? And as I say, we're already drifting out to sea. You know what I mean? And now we've got like this, you know, with the greatest of respect, overweight old lady clutching onto the back of the paddleboard. And that's bad enough. Now there's three of us. And she says, my friend, you've got to save my friend, my cousin. And I'm like, what? What are you talking about? And I look over there, and there's another old lady flailing about with her arms in the air. I'm like, for fuck's sake, this is ridiculous. So I swim over. I kind of get her. We get onto the paddleboard. My daughter comes over, you know, with the paddleboard. Next minute, and with the greatest of respect, you've got these two very, very heavily set old ladies clutching onto the paddleboard, right? And we're drifting. I'm like, listen. Listen, if you're going to hang on to the paddleboard, you're going to have to at least kick your legs, okay? Because in my mind, my first priority is me and my goddamn daughter.
Of course.
Not these two idiots, you know what I mean? I'm like, if we're going to go down, listen, don't make me choose. Don't make me choose. It's an easy choice. I choose me and my daughter. But they're just like hanging on and like the thing's nearly capsizing and like, you know, overturning. I'm like, for fuck's sake. So I said, right, so they all climb on the paddleboard. So there's three people on the paddleboard. I'm in the water, swimming along, trying to save them. And we're just getting nowhere, you know. So anyway, eventually, Kendall's sister, and who's a professional water polo player, by the way, so she's good in the water. her and a lifeguard turn up in a boat, in a kayak boat, should I say. They all climb into that, right? Kendall's sister-in-law, who's a professional water polo player, she gets on the paddleboard with my daughter. They disappear. The two old ladies disappear in a boat, and they're like, are you okay, Michael? And me being a fucking macho dickhead, going, yeah, I'm fine. I'll swim back, because there's no room for me. So they all disappear, go off into the distance, and I'm thinking, I don't fucking believe this. Me and my ego. Rather than just say, yes, I need help also, I'm going to drown in the water now. And they disappear into the distance, and I'm stuck out in the fucking water. Anyway, eventually the lifeguard came back, saved me as well. Got me, and we get back. And the old ladies are there, and they're like, oh, thank you so much. I said, oh, yeah, no problem. They said, but there was a third one. I'm like, what do you mean there was a third one? Like, yeah. She had flippers on. I said, oh, well, she'll be okay if she had flippers on. She said, no. The flippers have washed up to shore, but she hasn't. I'm like, oh, my God. Yeah, I swear to God. So we called 911 and this and that, but anyway. She came walking up. God knows where she was. I think she was getting a coffee or an ice cream or something.
Hilarious.
But, yeah, that was me yesterday. It was fun times.
That's fucking so funny. You were talking about it's an easy choice between your daughter and that old woman.
Well, yeah, because I'm thinking, listen, with the greatest respect, if we're all going to die here, you've lived a good life. You've got good innings. You've lived a good life. She's 14. I'm 38. Priority. Don't make me hit your fingers with the paddle. Because I'm going to knock you off. I'm joking.
You got the biggest fight of your career coming up. You can't fucking let these old bitches bring you down.
Exactly. I got it. Listen, I'm sorry, lady. Listen, you've had a good life, but I've got a big fight with GSP and she's 14. So get the fuck off the paddle boarders. I'm hitting her fingers with the paddle. And I'm joking. I would never kill an old lady out at sea.
I love how you have to preface it just because you have a fucking contract with the UFC that you wouldn't murder an old lady. I think they know you're kidding.
I definitely wouldn't murder an old lady out at sea unless my daughter's life depended on it. And even still then, I'd feel pretty bad about it.
Yeah.
You know, so, and I'm definitely joking for all those people listening and saying, God, he's a fucking asshole.
Well, I have a real question for you.
At the end of the day, I'm a hero. I'm a hero, Lewis.